All right, so in this video, we're gonna take a look at heat rocks. Probably one of the reptile equipment that gets hated on the most, and I'm gonna guess most people haven't even used them. So, in the earlier days, heat rocks were sort of the thing to help keep your animals warm, and I used them when I was a kid back in the early 90s for an iguana I had. And to my knowledge, I never really had an issue with it, but it seems to be an issue these days. People, you hear the same complaints over and over. It's they're junk, they're gonna burn your house down, they're gonna burn your animals. And well, I imagine that maybe those events have happened, but then again, pretty much any kind of heating device could do all of those same things. So we're going to take a look at these and see how they've changed from before, and what these companies are doing now to try to eliminate some of those issues. And I got the two popular brands. I have the Exoterra's heat rock, and I also have Zoomed's heat rock here. And so we'll open these up, take a look exactly what's going on inside, and then I'm going to run some tests and kind of just play around with them and see what happens with them. All right, so first off, we're gonna start by looking at the Exoterra's heat stone. Now you can see here on the front that it is thermal controlled. And so we're gonna open this up and take a look at exactly how that is controlled. I've not opened this before, so we're gonna see this together. There we go. Box opens up. What's that? So that's everything that's in there. So let's set that aside. Let's take a look at this rock. Kind of reminds me of a casting of a Bigfoot. So we simply just have a cord to plug in, nothing more than that. We've got some stuff here on the bottom. So it does say, let's see, do not immerse. Obviously it's electrical, you shouldn't be putting it in water. If not, well, that's your own issues. Let's see, let me go back to the box. Okay. Okay, so looking at the box here, it just simply says that it electronically controls the heat element, even heat distribution, fully encased element, so obviously we can't see the heating components. And there is a LED to indicate that it is on or off, which we have that right there. If you guys can kind of see, it's a little dark. And that's energy efficient. Let's see, I thought there was some more. So I guess that's it. You can't set it yourself. It's already apparently comes pre-programmed. So what we'll do is we're gonna set this aside. Later we'll go ahead and plug this thing in, and then we will take a look at what it's going on. Okay, so up next we're gonna take a look at the Zoomed heat rock. It's actually a little bit smaller than the other one, but nonetheless, we're still gonna give it a try. Here's the back panel for it. Now this one does come with a controller, so you can actually set, yeah, get the lights out of there. So that way you can actually set it yourself. Looks pretty much similar design as far as the Exoterra's, everything's inside there. Almost reminds me of like heat tape, just encased in a rock. So let's go ahead and get this thing open and get this out. Oh, That's everything. Paperwork. Let's take a look at this. It's rather rough. Okay, so I'll get you, well, we're out of screen here. I'll get you guys a better close-up, but we essentially just have a high, or an off, low, medium, and high. So I guess there really isn't too much control. And then they've got in here in their paperwork for winter, spring, summer, two sets of summers, and fall. And then they kind of tell you when to have that on, if that will focus. So that's pretty much it. Pretty much same design, and that's actually a rather little rough around the edges. I don't know if we can quite see that. I'll get you a better photo here in a moment. But this feels more like a porcelain, whereas the other one, I'm not sure what that's made out of. So, controller, whatnot. So, let me get the other one. Chipped it already. We'll get the other one set up here. We'll do a side-by-side and get you a closer look. Okay, so here's the two units setting side-by-side again. This is the ZooMed. Comes with a controller, somewhat of a controller. This is the Exoterra. Apparently it's all controlled by itself. We just simply plug it in. So what we're going to do is I'm going to set these two rocks up and we're going to do some experimenting with them and just kind of let them run and see what they do. Okay, so what I've done is connected both heat rocks to this power strip and then I simply turned them both on at the exact same time just by the flip of that switch.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of my sea. Oh, ooh.
Okay, so what you just watched there was pretty much an entire day of just GoPro footage filming those heat rocks, and I just obviously time-lapsed it by put the clock in there so that way you guys could kind of see that it was a continuous thing. There is a few little jumps in time, but that's only because the GoPros stopped sooner than I had anticipated, and that lapse is just me from the camera stopping till the time I discovered that they had stopped recording. And then what you also notice is it was GoPro 1, GoPro 2, and then GoPro 1. What I did was is I recorded with the first GoPro till it ran out. I already had the second GoPro charged and ready, loaded that one into the spot, which I missed getting the temperature only because that GoPro does not have a screen on the back, so I couldn't see exactly what it was filming. But anyways, while the second GoPro was recording, I was recharging the first GoPro, and then once it was charged, I flipped back to it. So that's the scenario that was happening there. But as you can tell, the ZooMed heat rock did get quite a bit warmer, but to be fair, that one was also set to high. And so, you know, both seem to be pretty good. I am kind of liking the Exoterra a little bit more, just because it's, the other one kind of feels, it's like a porcelain. The ZooMed one is porcelain, and it just, when you tap on it, kind of sounds like glass. It's a little bit heavier, but it's smaller. I just like the flatter surface of the Exoterra, and, you know, so I think both products are pretty decent for what they do. And just like any heating element, any electrical unit you're using and around your reptiles, they should be constantly monitored regularly and double check that they're not getting too hot. Now, I think heat rocks can still work in most situations. Of course, they're not the, you know, there are some other things that are better alternatives. But, you know, I don't think heat rocks are as bad as, you know, people like to hate on them for. And, you know, if you're careful with them, you pay attention to them, just like anything else, the heating mats, the under tank heating mats, the heat tape, the overhead heats, the lights. I mean, I've seen it all in my time, you know, go bad and bad things happen with all of that stuff. So, you know, I think heat rocks kind of get a little bit of a bad rap. But if you use them, just use cautious with them, as you should with any heating electrical element around your reptiles. So that's going to be it for this video. If you have an ideal for me to test against these rocks for another video, certainly leave those comments below, and if I can do it, I certainly will and make a video of it. Obviously, I kind of would like to see what it's like when the temperature is like 80, 90, the ambient temperature, and how those heat rocks would handle those situations, what exactly they do. As you can see, it was about just over 70, which is actually the warmest day so far this year. Shouldn't be though. And you can kind of see how they held out. The Exoterra kind of held at that 94 point, you know, 93, 94. And then of course the ZoomEd went up. I don't remember right off the top of my head, but I think I did see it go down to like 116, 117. You know, again, the ZoomEd was on high. We could probably play around with the other settings, but I figured if it's cold, if the ambient temperature is way colder than what the rock is going to be, and I have it up on high, I figured that would be the most amount of stress that rock would have. But I don't know. You know, future testings will probably figure something else out. I don't know. So if you have an idea, go ahead, comment below. And like I said, if I can get it into a video, I definitely will. As long as it truly isn't going to be fire causing or something, you know, like we're not going to wrap it up in like blankets or something like that and see what it does. You know, something like that's just ridiculous. If it's an ideal that would be within a reasonable use of these heat rocks, I'm willing to give it a try. So leave those comments down below. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. And until next time, later.
Shut up and sit down.